You are watching TMG School, delivering technology.
Hello, welcome to MCRPV Wings on TMG School. In yesterday's session, we have seen the introduction to C programming. We learned how to write a Hello World program, how to write interactive programs and specifically the use of printf and scanf. Then we came across some new arithmetic also. 20,000 plus 20,000 equals minus 25,536. Well, how does it happen? I'm really curious to know how we got that answer. Well, without wasting any further time, let's join Professor Raju in the classroom session.
I hope you have had time to think about what we learned last time. And let me start by taking a quick review of what we did last time. So we learned, first of all, how to write a basic C program, a Hello World program as it is called. The next thing we learnt was how to write an interactive program and specifically how to use printf and scanf. We learnt the elements of debugging, what happens if you fail to use the ampersand with scanf. And then we learnt about the format specifiers. There were a number of format specifiers that we learnt about. Percentage D, percentage O, percentage X for hex. And we also saw that depending on the format specifier you use, 21 may mean 21, or 21 may mean 17, or 21 may mean 33. And we saw, of course, the basic arithmetic operators, star, multiplication, division, addition, and we did some elementary sums. And we also learnt some of the things that are not mentioned in common texts, not mentioned at least in many texts, that one byte is not necessarily equal to 8 bits. Sometimes, many times perhaps, but not necessarily. It is not part of the standard in the language. It is implementation dependent. And we learnt some new arithmetic. We learnt that if you add two integers, 2 plus 2 is 4, but 20,000 plus 20,000 is minus 25536. So now that you have had some time to reflect about this, I would like to ask you, how did this happen? So would anybody like to try? How did this happen?
Yeah. Sir, I think the total limit of integer from minus 32768 to plus 32767, it's the sum of, total sum of 65535. And the resultant is our minus 25536. The limit, the subtraction, which is met by 20,000 plus 20,000 is equal to 40,000. And when we subtract from 65536, the result is 25536.
Why should we subtract from that?
The limit, sir?
Yeah, and I mean, country, after all, when I write a program,
yeah,
what I want is that it should add integers. What I expect is that just as it gives me 2 plus 2 is 4, it should give me 20,000 plus 20,000 is 40,000. So I first of all want to know why it happened, and I want to know how to fix this problem. Because only if I understand the cause, then I can hope to fix it. So this is not clear enough. I want a precise calculation of how it came about. You know, C programmer is concerned with internals. Has to go into all details, should understand each bit.
Yeah.
So I would like a very clear answer why such a thing happens at all. A clearer answer. Would somebody else like to try?
So Sir, usually, sir, an integer sir occupies 2 bytes in memory, and usually that has 16 bits. Sir, there is one sign bit which represents whether the number is positive or negative. And when the sign bit is 0, it represents positive numbers, and then it can represent the maximum number, that is 32767. Sir, when the value of this integer...
Where did this value come from?
Sir,
you're repeating this value.
The rest of bits are on, that is 111.
No, why is it 32767? Why not something else?
Because sir, the rest is 15 bits. If they are on, they represent the maximum value.
Supposing I had a 47-bit int.
Yes, sir.
What would happen?
Actually, for a single bit, there is two possibilities. It may be 0 or it may be 1. Mm-hmm. If every bit contains one true value, then there arises a possibility of 2 to the power 23 for 1 and 2 to the power 23 for 0. So it's totally...
No, it's not at all clear. It's not clear. Because why should I add in this fashion? Would you like to try?
Sir, computer always calculate the calculation as done on the bits. Usually the one byte contains 8 bits. So as you have said that one byte contains 47 bits, so then when the calculation goes from bit by bit, when all the bits are on, means 1, then the limit of the one byte will be to the power 46.
Let me put my question very precisely. Is it the case, are you suggesting that in this big system, I am not able to calculate beyond 40,000? A simple pocket calculator can do that.
Yes, sir.
Right? Now, I am writing a big C program. And if I write a big C program, I should be able to do better than that. So, I want to do better than that. Right? I want to do better than that. And the question now is that if I have to do better than that, what should I do? So, I want to understand the cause very precisely. It's not sufficient to know in a general kind of a way that, all right, some limitation is there. Obviously, some limitation is there. But I must know precisely what has happened in order to be able to change it, in order to be able to rectify the problem, in order to be able to do a calculation which is at least as good as a calculator. After all, 20,000 is not much. How did the people arrive at this figure? Why did they arrive at it? And how is it that if I cannot use a computer to add two integers correctly? Okay, so let us try and understand this problem as clearly as possible. Because if one is dealing with a machine, it is not possible to give a general kind of an idea. The machine is not going to understand some generalities. You have to make a very precise kind of statement in order to be able to rectify things. All right? So let us try and understand this integer data type very thoroughly. When you declare an integer, when you say int A, you said what it means is, this is an instruction that the computer should, when the program is executing, it should reserve a certain amount of memory to hold the values of the variable A. How much memory? We saw it is 2 bytes. And how much is 2 bytes? We have seen that it is usually, but not always, 16 bits. And what is a bit? It is either 0 or 1. Alright, so you have 16 places, each of which can store either a 0 or a 1. Alright? Now let us see what has happened. So, when we are looking at integer, when the computer is looking at it, let's try and think about it now from the computer's point of view. Computer is looking at the integer, so it looks like a bit pattern. Alright? But how does this bit pattern correspond to a number? We need to understand that thoroughly. Because we can see that there is a bit pattern, and we can see that in a general kind of a way that answer is correct, that the number 40,000 is too large to be represented by this bit pattern. But what is the logic for minus 25536? Is it some junk value or is it going to come every time? A computer program is supposed to behave the same way each time. So my assertion would be that this is not a junk value. It is a specific value, and each time you run the program, you will get exactly the same value. All right, it's not that each time you'll get a new value. So let us try and understand the logic by means of which the computer arrived at this decision in order to be able to fix it at some stage if we want to fix it, because surely we want to be able to add large numbers. So let us start by looking at a simplified situation. So we are looking at the binary representation of a number when we have only 4 bits. We simplify it because the human mind can more easily grasp 4 symbols. So let us look at a bit pattern. I call it A3, A2, A1, A0. All right. Each one of these AIs is a bit. So it is either a 0 or a 1. Now in the binary representation of numbers, I would interpret this as A3 into 2 to the power 3 plus A2 into 2 to the 2 square plus A1 into 2 plus A0. 2 to the power 0 is 1. So, for example, if I have the bit pattern 0, 1, 1, 1 and I am using 4 bits, then it would correspond to the number 0 plus 1 into 2 square, so that is 4. Plus 1 into 2, so that's 2, plus 1. So that corresponds to 7. So 0, 1, 1, 1 corresponds to 7. But is this the system that the computer uses? This is not what it uses. This is not what it uses. It uses something like this, but not exactly this. This is the binary representation. And there is a problem, the binary representation, because you have a fixed width. 4 bits, 16 bits, whatever number of bits you have fixed width. So what are the problems? There are 2 problems. First, you cannot represent negative numbers. Only non-negative numbers are represented in this fashion. Because what do you do for minus sign? That's one thing. Second thing is that the maximum integer that you can represent with 4 bits, you have only so many different symbols. If you have only so many different symbols, you have only 15 different symbols, you can represent only 15 different numbers. That's about the maximum that you could do with 4 bits. Well, what's the general situation? General situation is that if you have n bits, then you will get a geometric series or a geometric progression. I hope all of you have done this geometric progression in school, and we know how to sum this up. Because the series is going to go as 2 to the power n minus 1 plus 2 to the power n minus 2 and so on. And we know what the sum of the series is. Alright. So, we are first of all able to calculate from the sum of the series that it is going to be 2 to the power n minus 1. Not whole thing to the power n minus 1, 2 to the power n minus 1. We subtract 1 from that. So, for example, if it is 4 bits, then we take 2 to the power 4, which is 16 minus 1, which is 15. And if it is 16 bits, then we take 2 to the power 16 and subtract 1. So, we have 65,535 different possibilities. And that incidentally is the maximum value for the unsigned data type. Now, what do we do for signed numbers? This is one possibility that we have got. That we reserve 1 bit for the sign. So, if that bit happens to be 1, then we say the number is negative. And otherwise, we express positive numbers the way we have been expressing them. So, for example, now if I take, supposing now I take for a change 8 bits, and I look at 1000 and 0001, this will then be the sign magnitude representation of minus 1. But is that the system that C uses? C doesn't quite use this system either. It doesn't use this system. Why doesn't it use this system? Because there is a certain problem. What's the problem? Let us see the problem. So, there is in fact more than one problem. So, the first problem is with 0. If we look at the bit pattern which has got 1 in the first place and zeros everywhere else, this should be a negative number because the sign bit is 1. But it cannot be negative of anything, it has to be negative of 0. Now this is something which is contrary to the normal arithmetic that you learn, because the negative of 0 or the additive inverse of 0 is itself 0. So you have to have something called a negative 0 in computational arithmetic, which is then a bit different from the normal arithmetic. And we could live with that because there have been a lot of problems with 0. As you know, the basic method of addition and multiplication and so on, the reason to call it algorithm is that there was this Al-Khwarizmi. Al-Khwarizmi was an Arab mathematician and writer who translated the texts of Brahmagupta and so on. And the Latinization of his name of Al-Khwarizmi was Algorithmus. And it is from there that one gets the term algorithm. And when these techniques of addition and multiplication that you are familiar with, when they first went to Europe, Europe was using the abacus. You know, that toy in kindergarten, but it was not a toy those days. You have many learned people, including the Pope, writing on the abacus. So they also wrote on the algorithmus, starting from the 10th century. And this went on for about 500 years until ultimately the algorithmus texts, they replaced the abacus texts. And one of the reasons for this confusion, there's a lot of confusion, was this notion of zero, which was not clear, that you have something and you discard it. You know, not perhaps as profound as Shunya in Nagarjuna's Shunyavad, but nevertheless, there was a lot of confusion about this zero. So we could live with two zeros, but there is a much more serious problem. The problem is that if you perform a very simple sum, namely we take 1 and we take minus 1. So what is minus 1? It means it should have the same bit pattern as 1, except that the first bit should be now 1. So if we add the 2, then what we should get is 0, but what we actually get is minus 2. So this kind of an arithmetic is extremely peculiar, that 1 and plus minus 1 gives you minus 2 instead of giving you 0. And that's an even bigger confusion about 0, I suppose, which has been invented. And therefore, we have to abandon this sign magnitude representation. It doesn't work. We need to change it. All right. So what do? We try the what is called the 1's complement. This is a second method in which we use the 1's complement to represent negative numbers. So what is 1's complement? 1's complement of a bit pattern is obtained by changing zeros to 1 and 1's to 0. So if we have, let us say, a bit pattern, well, it's called a number there. Actually, it should be called a bit pattern because we are not quite clear what number it corresponds to at the moment. So if we look at a bit pattern 0, 1, 0, 1, then the 1 complement of that will be 1010. Now, the way we interpret this bit pattern is that all numbers beginning with a 1 are regarded as negative. So, minus A would be represented by 1 complement of A. That's the idea for positive A. All right. So, what happens with this 1's complement representation? Supposing we have 8 bits, working with 8 bits. Let us try and obtain the 1's complement representation of minus 38. So first we take the binary representation of 38. We know how to obtain that. So the bit pattern that is given here is 0, 0, 1, 0, then 0, 1, 1, 0. So it corresponds to 32 plus 4 plus 2, which I think totals up to 38. So we take the 1 complement of this, so we replace all zeros by 1's and all 1's by 0's. I hope that is done correctly. That gives us minus 38. Now, if we add these two, in fact, if we add any two complemented bit patterns, we are bound to get all 1's. Because where we had 1, we put 0. Where we had 0, we put 1. So, we are going to get all 1's. So, what is this thing with all 1's? Since any number and its negative should give us this, this ought to be something like 0. So, in fact, it is the 1 complement of 0, because 0 has all 0's, so it should be something like negative 0 once more. So, perhaps we could live with that. But we have, you know, this can arise in different ways. If you subtract 1 from 0, then also you would get the same kind of bit pattern. And this creates a serious problem. So you don't want this kind of a problem. It is because, in a sense, you know, 1 is playing the role of also 1 and 9, the way you would have in the decimal system or decimal representation. And so you have borrowed, and then it goes on like that. And this creates a major problem, because you don't want 0 minus 1 to be the same thing as 38 minus 38. So how do you fix this? So you can try and fix this problem by using what is called 2's complement. So you use 2's complement. So what is 2's complement? It's a straightforward ad hoc kind of a solution. You take the 1 complement of a number, add 1 to it. And that makes that sum come out correctly. Okay? But now there is a problem. If you look at the 1 complement representation of minus 1, then it should be exactly, you know, we have 1 and we complement it, and we should get 1 all ones everywhere and 0 at the last place. And if we add 1 to it, then it becomes all ones. So now all ones is to be interpreted in the 2 complement representation as minus 1. So now I will finally get 0 minus 1 as minus 1. All right. So now I am able to do my arithmetic correctly with the 2's complement to some extent. But the problem still persists. What is the problem? We have a new problem. See, no matter how you try to sort it out, there is going to be some problem. So this is intrinsic to the nature of things, that the arithmetic that you do with the computer is going to be somewhat different from the arithmetic that you learnt. So we look at 127 plus 1. So if you look at 127, then 127 is going to be, you know, all the 7 bits I want to be 1. Of course, the first bit can't be 1 because that is the sign bit. I want a positive number, so that should be 0. So I have 127 and I have 1. But now if I add it, then 1 and 1 gives me 0, there is a carry of 1, and this carry progresses, and ultimately I end up with a number which has 1 in the first place and 0 everywhere else. And this then is the 2 complement representation of minus 128 with 8 bits. So effectively what I have got is 127 plus 1 gives me minus 128. So this is the logic behind it, that I am using the 2's complement representation, and if I use the 2's complement representation, then this is the kind of thing that happens. Now we can calculate it more precisely. We did that for 8 bits. We can do the same thing for 16 bits. And if we do it for 16 bits, then 32767 plus 1 gives us minus 32768. That's the exact logic. I hope it is quite clear. If you are taking the 2's complement, not the sign magnitude representation, not the 1 complement representation, there could be various representations possible. So we are using the 2's complement representation, and because we use the 2's complement representation, we are able to get addition correctly, but only up to a certain range. Beyond that, it is going to wrap around. Instead of a number line, you have got something like a number circle. So once you are at the edge of this circle, you add 1, then you topple back to the bottom, and then you progress from there. So that is how the computer is carrying out the addition. So it adds correctly up to 32767, and thereafter it wraps around. So if we look at 40,000, you know, it goes correctly up to, supposing it is incrementing by 1, it goes correctly up to 32767, then it increments 1 and topples like snakes and ladders, you know, it goes all the way down to the bottom, and then it starts incrementing from there. So it still has to increment another 7532. And it does that, and that is how it arrives at 25536. That's the logic of that sum.
The integer data type, the declaration int a, is an instruction to the compiler to reserve a certain amount of memory to hold the values of the variable a. Limitations of the binary representation with fixed width. This method can represent only non-negative integers. In C language, non-negative integers are represented by the data type unsigned int. The maximum integer that can be represented with 4 bits is 2.3 plus 2.2 plus 2.1 plus 2.0 equals to 15. The maximum integer that can be represented with n bits is 2n minus 1 plus 2n minus 2 plus 2n minus 3, so on up to 20 equals to 2n minus 1. Hence, the maximum integer that can be represented with 16 bits is 65535. This is the maximum value for the unsigned data type.
Very complicated indeed, but finally I've got the answer and hope so. You also might be satisfied with Professor Raj's explanation of 20,000 plus 20,000 equals minus 25,536. A complex usage of integer data types with 1's complement and 2's complement has finally got us the answer. Time now for a short break. After the break, we will confirm the logic of minus 25,536 by writing a small program. Stay tuned.
You are watching TMG School, delivering technology. There's one world and one way. Technology leads the way. Information is king. And you need to be tuned in. Get your finger on the pulse. With Indian IT Online, get insights into IT news, the IT scenario, the web, the IT calendar, newsmakers and the latest technologies. Log on to IndianITOnline.com, the Indian IT portal. You are watching TMG School, delivering technology.
Welcome back. C language today is one of the widely used languages in the computer world. C has now become a widely used professional language. The reasons for this are its high level of constructs for the efficiency of its programs. Moreover, the main reason for its popularity is that it can be compiled on a variety of computers. This indeed makes C a very user-friendly and popular language. Let's now join Professor Raju for a continued discussion on arithmetic or adding of two numbers.
Form this logic by writing a simple program. Okay, so here's the program. So the program is, it will actually demonstrate this addition on the system. So we do hash include values dot h. The other things we have been through. And the new thing here is this max int. We will just take a look at it. So here is the program on the Turbo C IDE, and let us run it and see what happens. So what we have is 32767 plus 1 is equal to minus 32768, as we expected on the basis of our computation. So that's the output which we expected. You have just seen it in the actual program. And now I would like to demonstrate something which we were talking about, that a byte is not necessarily 8 bits, and that 2 bytes is not necessarily 16 bits. That this is implementation dependent. And you could guess that because there is this question of max int. Why is this max int needed? Because we used values dot h for max int. But why do you need to have a special constant? Just because it is implementation dependent. So if you were to look at a Win32 platform, on a Win32 platform, an int would be 32 bits. And let us check this out by running this addint program in Visual C++. So this is the same program. Addint.c, and I now want to run it with a different IDE. So you are probably not familiar with this IDE. It is the Visual C++ IDE. So let us run it in this and see what we get. So let us try 20,000. So the answer turns out to be 40,000. So Visual C++ can do a better job with adding the couple of integers. But see, nothing has really changed, because if you were to put in enough number of zeros, you would again start getting some peculiar arithmetic. All right. So nothing has changed. The principles are all the same, but the word length is now different. So that's the essential difference that we have. And well, to get back to where we were, maybe if you are not familiar with using the Visual C++ IDE, it would be a good idea. It's a very straightforward thing. If you want to run this program, all you have to do is you have to click File, New, create a new workspace. A Win32 console application is what you have to select. That's the important thing. Create an empty project, add a file to the project. So it's a straightforward approach, and then just build it and run it as you just saw it being run. So it is useful to have different IDEs, because you should not rely exclusively on one IDE which is somewhat out of date. Not somewhat, substantially out of date, although it is still extremely convenient. Turbo C is very convenient. A lot of people grew up like that. Of course, you can, if you make mistakes and so on, you don't have to necessarily run the program. You can compile it, link it, and so on. IDE will offer you all sorts of facilities. So please do try that if you have access to the Visual C++ IDE. You can do the same kind of thing in Turbo C. All you need is what is called the long modifier. So if you use the long modifier, then the number of bits that you have now for a long int is 32 bits. So 32 bits of storage. Doesn't change the principle. You're still adding, there's still the same wraparound property, but the values have changed. It doesn't happen at so low a level of 20,000 as you saw in the case of Visual C++. You need much larger numbers in order for the wraparound to take place. How large? Since we have done the general theory, it is quite easy to calculate that, and we simply apply it. You just have to calculate powers of 2. And you can look that up if you like, if you don't recollect it. So the exact figure is given on the slide, and that is where the wrapping around takes place. But there is no other change. Basic principles are the same. The number of bits has changed. The modifiers long and unsigned can be used together. So you could have unsigned A, and you could have long B, and you could have unsigned long int C. All these are valid declarations. So when you do unsigned, then you would be getting only the numbers from 0 to how much? If you do unsigned, what are the numbers you would get? What is the range you will get?
0 to 6, 5, 5, 3, 5.
Correct. And if you add 1 to that, what will happen?
It will give the value minus 65536.
No, that's not correct. If I am doing with an unsigned int, that is not what will happen, because I cannot store that entire range of values. What will happen if I add 1 to it?
So 65536.
No, I can't represent that value. So what will happen? Somebody else wants to try? No, it will not be an overflow, it will not be 65536, it will not be minus anything. You have tried almost all possibilities. Somebody else wants to try?
So minus 65534.
No, that's not correct. You already gave that answer. That's not correct. Would you like to try?
No.
Wouldn't like to try that? Okay. Then you haven't had time to assimilate what we have done, perhaps I have been going a little too fast. What will happen with an unsigned? With an unsigned, if you add 1, then you should go back to 0. You cannot have signed values being represented there, so the wraparound works, but the limits are now 0 to 65535. And similarly, if you now take an unsigned long, then the limits will increase, but it will not wrap around to negative value, it will wrap around to 0. That is what will happen. Alright, this is essentially what happens.
Time now for a short break, but there's a lot more to follow after that. Stay tuned.
You are watching TMG School, delivering technology. It takes skill to put things together. It takes perseverance to get the right notes. It takes an idea to bring things to life. Discover how the internet can add meaning to your life. Zindagi Online, inspired by life. Every evening at 7:10 p.m. only on TMG Enter. You are watching TMG School, delivering technology.
Welcome back to MCRPV Wings on TMG School. C language's main drawback is that it has poor error detection, which can make it difficult for the beginner. However, diligence in this matter can pay off handsomely, since having learned the rules of C, we can break them. Not many languages allow this. This, if done properly and carefully, leads to the power of C programming. Over to Professor Raju now to see some more interesting aspects of C programming.
So if you do unsigned long or long unsigned, it doesn't matter. It is both of them essentially mean the same thing. And not essentially, there is no difference between them. And this is the kind of equation you would have for unsigned long, which is now 4294967295 plus 1 gives you 0. Now, if you try to do something like long short, you know, apply two different modifiers which are contradictory, then that will generate a compiler error to the effect that there are too many types in the declaration. What about long long? Long long is something which is obviously desirable. And this desire is fulfilled in the C99 standard, which has a long long data type. It permits such a data type. But since Turbo C is an old compiler, even Visual C++ is not new enough in a sense to take into account the C standard. Of course, the latest version, we are not talking about that, we are talking about Visual C++ 6.0. So it doesn't accept a long long data type, but such a data type exists and you should be aware of its existence. So we write one more program, and in this program the key thing is that we are making use of limits.h. We are hash including limits.h. So in limits.h we have a variety of limits which will give us the limits for short, long, etc., unsigned long and so on. And we can then print these out. And when you print these out, especially if you are using the modifier long, please note the format specifications that we have got. You will need a percentage LD or a percentage LU at some stage in order to print these things out. Otherwise, they would not print correctly. The rest of the program is here. And if we run it, then you get the results which are straight away there without your having to compute it. Of course, if you like to compute it, it is good. But even if you are not computing it, you can just write this little program and get it. So we have the values of short integer, which you have already seen. Likewise, we have the values for long integer, maximum and minimum, which we have checked out. For maximum unsigned long, it is also this value I have already stated. And if you add 1 to each one of them, then for the int types, you wrap around to the negative value, which goes to the minimum. And it always goes to the minimum, but for the unsigned, the minimum is 0. So for the unsigned, it goes to 1. It goes to 0. If you add 1, it goes to 0. All right? So I hope that that makes the issue completely clear. And perhaps as an exercise, you could try and work out why it is going to 0. It should be quite straightforward. I have shown you the program to see that it actually transpires in this fashion. Now, I would like to ask you one question. So let us go back to this addint.c program. And now I want to make a certain change. The change I wish to make in this program is, instead of c equal to a plus b, I want to make the change c equal to a minus b. All right? Now, I am going to run this program. And I am going to enter a as 40,000. All right? And I am going to enter b as 20,000. Now, what is the value that I will get? What is the answer I will get? So, the program is supposed to subtract b from a. So, now if I take 40,000 and if I subtract 20,000 from it, what am I going to get? What's the answer?
I think, sir, it is minus 5536.
Minus 5536. Anybody else wants to try?
Yeah. Sir, 12,767.
12,767. Yeah. Somebody should keep writing now. Anybody else wants to try? You want to try? Yeah, please try.
Sir, minus 12,768.
All right. So, all your answers are wrong. The answer is 20,000. See, in a manner of speaking, what is happening is that when you add, you are rolling in this direction. When you subtract, you are going in the opposite direction. So, you start from minus 25,536 and you roll back by 20,000, you come to the right point, which is 20,000. So, it's not able to represent 40,000 correctly. It's not able to, but it's able to represent 20,000 correctly. So, the answer that you get is correct, even though the value of A that is being printed out is wrong. All right? So, even though, 20,000 plus 20,000 gives you minus 25,536, it is nevertheless, when you subtract, 40,000 minus 20,000 is still correct. So, I hope that you are getting some feel for how the computer does arithmetic.
Till now, we have seen various programs using Max in program for printf and scanf. Let's take a short break here. Stay tuned for more coming up after that.
You are watching TMG School, delivering technology.
Catch your dream technology careers on Breakthrough every night at 8:35 p.m. and again at 10:35 p.m. only on TMG Enter.
You're watching TMG School, delivering technology.
Welcome back. In the previous session, we heard that 2 bytes is not always 16 bits. Sounds interesting. An int is 2 bytes but not necessarily 16 bits. But if we take it on a Win32 platform, an int is always 32 bits. Let's now join Professor Raju in the classroom session to know more.
So since this seems to be something interesting, and just to make sure that your understanding in the matter is perfected, I have given you a number of programs to write. Now, let us imagine that one of you writes the program. And well, I have displayed the program, and you write it, and then you run it. But the result that you get is not the result that I showed you. You get a different result. And that result is the following. So, let us look at it a bit closely. Let's examine it closely. And the maximum unsigned long integer is turning out to be 65535. Now, is that correct? And if it is not correct, can you tell me what is the mistake in the program?
Sorry, using D in the place of LU, the format specifier for unsigned
using
long integer?
D in place of LU.
Yeah.
It's not correct. Anybody else wants to try?
Sir, the format specifier is wrong. And sir, you used percentage LD in place of percentage LU.
I used percentage LD in place of LU.
No, sir.
That's also not correct. Somebody else wants to try?
Sir, the format specifier is wrong. You have used only percentage U instead of percentage LU.
That's correct. Format specifier is wrong, all of you are right, but then you have to think of what you are saying. If I use percentage D, then I cannot possibly get the output 65535. Can I get such an output with percentage D? Because percentage D will give me an int. And for an int, I already know that the limits are 32767. All right, so it is not possible for me to get 65535. Now, you said it is percentage LD. Now, if it is percentage LD, then I should get a larger number. Isn't it? If you like, we can put percentage LD there and check. Okay, so I put percentage LD there, and now I want to run this. What I get is something which is a bit different. What I get is now maximum unsigned long integer is minus 1. All right. So it doesn't quite, that's the reason why I said that's not correct. But obviously you are right that it is the format specifier that is wrong. So if you are debugging the program, you would have got to that point and you would have presumably corrected it. So I hope that clarifies something about these the range that we have for an integer. And I hope that in future you would be able to fix this. So now we have got this restricted range. Supposing I want to do arithmetic the way in which I am accustomed to doing arithmetic. Is it possible on a computer? I would like to have your opinion. That is first question. And the second question is, if it is possible, how should it be done? And if it is not possible, what is the best that can be done? So I would like your responses to that.
Yeah, it is possible. But as there is some limitations of the data types we use, if we increase their limit, then it is possible that what we do in general arithmetic calculation we can perform on computer also.
So there is no change according to you. We can continue with the 2's complement way of addition.
Yes.
But if we continue with the 2's complement way of addition, no matter how big you make, at some stage it will wrap around.
Yes, sir. So for this, if we can increase the limit of any data types, such as that, as in C, the integer value has 2 bytes and which is 16 bits. Whereas when we see that...
Suppose, just to interrupt you, suppose we have now in C99, we have introduced a long, long type. Now we introduce a long, long, long type. And perhaps we introduce a long, 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 long type. Alright. So we introduce a large number of such types. Still, even if it is long, 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 what will happen is that there will be a large number of digits. But after that, there will be a problem, won't there?
Yes, sir.
So I would like you to address that problem. Do you think it is possible to get across that problem? Would somebody else like to comment on that?
If we go by this way, by using long, long and or anything, so on and so forth, it will not be computable as what we do. For that, we have to increase the bits limit for any data type.
That's what is done. When I do a long, long, When I do a long, I have increased the number of bits. When I do a long, long, I have increased the number of bits further. When I do a long, 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 I have increased it further. So I go on doing long, 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 long. All right, so I have a very long int. But has the problem been fixed? That's the question. Would you would like to comment something? Somebody would like to say something on this? You have to think about it? I mean, as a matter of fact, if you look at the way in which Aryabhatta does arithmetic, he does arithmetic in a different way. He does arithmetic with fixed number of symbols. He will have names for powers of 10, which go up to, I think, about 10 to the power 24 or something like that, or maybe 10 to the power 26. He goes up to that point. And you'll find people going further. But then, none of the traditional tracts that I have seen ever has this conceptualization of the integers as something which flow on infinitely. So, in fact, I would like to suggest that if one wants to do arithmetic with a finite number of symbols, and probably if some of you have heard something about this notion of a Turing machine, I should not bring it in here. But the idea is it's a computer which has an infinite amount of memory, but actual real computers always have finite amount of memory. If you have finite amount of memory, you are limited, you can only represent so many numbers. Doesn't matter how large the memory is. Memory may be extremely large, you can represent extremely large integers. As we see, if you look at unsigned long, it's a very large number. And if you look at unsigned long long, it will be an even larger number. So, when it becomes such a large number, then one is somewhat satisfied. But still, the problem in some sense persists in principle. So, it is in fact a question of principle, in a sense, how exactly arithmetic should be done, how exactly the integers should be conceptualized. But I hope you have got this idea very clearly, that the way the computer does arithmetic for integers is not quite the same as the way in which you were taught arithmetic. And I hope you will reflect on this in the future, on what can be done about this. Thank you.
Well, that's it for today in MCRPV Wings. Feel free to send in all your queries and feedback to mcrpv_tmg@yahoo.com. In fact, the best query for each episode will carry a prize sponsored by Makanlal Chaturvedi Rashtriya Patrakarita Vishwavidyalay. Until we meet again, from all of us here at the MCRPV Wings desk, it's goodbye.
Watching TMG School, delivering technology.
IT news, views and analysis is TMG News. Watch TMG News every hour on the hour, only on TMG Enter. Coming up next.
You're watching TMG School, delivering technology.